How are things going?
Amazing. How are things going for you?
I'm ready to rock and roll, baby, because that's our theme today. We're first going to go get some motorbikes. And no, I can't ride. And do you ever, can you ride?
A four-wheeler.
Okay, so we're on the back of motorbikes. And then we're heading to the most talked about tattoo parlor in Johannesburg. It's called Fallen Heroes. And I'm going to get a nice tattoo of my son, Noah. And then somewhere on my body.
Oh, nice. And then we're going to have a special VIP breakfast at Craft in Parkhurst. If you're in Parkhurst and you've never been to Craft, then you're totally missing out.
I got great milkshakes.
And then we're going to have maybe some late afternoon drinks at House Kitchen and head over to an early dinner at the Potato Shed. We'll be visiting the best spots, best places, and also best foodie joints. Let's rock it out.
Rock and roll, baby.
The two bikes we've prepped for you guys today is our two R90s, one with an alloy tank and the other one with a series spec. I'm sure you will have lots of fun with both of them.
If you really want to live the rock and roll lifestyle, though, you ride your bike and then what?
And then you get tattoos.
You get tattooed.
Are you going to get tattooed up?
All over my body.
Really?
Just ink
face
me.
Face as well?
Ink me.
Okay. What is this ladylike tat?
Bah! I was thinking back of arm. Maybe chest, ribs.
Ribs? You're trying to make sure that it's something you like and you don't mind living with forever.
But I know but what I want. I want my son's name.
Well, that's amazing.
All I have to do is choose the font and we're over away.
Nothing like a man who knows what he runs.
Hi, my name is Tace, owner of Fallen Heroes Tattoo and Art. We're in Parkhurst and we make pretty pictures. Jen, my wife, and I have from the start decided we wanted a place where anyone can come to. We work on a commission base, we do the advertising, and then the artists do the tattoos. So you wash my back, I wash yours. We've got 8 artists at the moment, and they're pretty fully booked. They keep busy. We've got a good, healthy competition. People will always motivate each other, or will one-up each other, which kind of motivates as well. Brian Graham Durant is working on Janez today. He's a great artist. He taught himself, managed to do a great job at it. I think influences us every day. I look up to him for everything he does. He tackles it straight on and usually always gets a great result. We'll be right back.
We're done. Wow. Brian, you're an absolute master.
My youngest son's name, Noah. A thing of beauty. What I can tell you guys is that I've built up quite an appetite and I need some sugar because I'm feeling a little.
Thank you, Brian. I really appreciate it.
A pleasure.
Thank you, brother. Should I put my shirt on for the rest
Please.
Of the episode?
Yeah.
Or can I just roll like this?
It's pretty cold, but if you want to roll like that, you're more than welcome. We're going to Craft and Parkhurst. It is one of the spots that you shouldn't miss. I've tried to go there before. It was so full. I got bounced. Can you believe it?
That's
bounced
good.
From Craft.
I know Craft, everyone always says it's got the best milkshakes in Johannesburg, hands down. I mean, people go there specifically just to have a milkshake.
Yeah, it also has like really dope real food. They don't use a lot of processed stuff. So if you're looking for like old school way of making food and like really yummy stuff, they've got great food as well as the milkshake. So it's an all-rounder.
Look at that, VIP parking up front.
Well, when you
look, it's pumping, man. Of course it's an institution.
I'm Joe Pinheiro.
And I'm Chris Mendoz.
We're the owners of Craft Parkhurst. Craft has been around for in excess of two and a half years. We opened up on the 18th of December, 2013. We opted to do it during that period of time in the hope that everyone would be away on holiday and we could easily ease in and trade in. And we just started off with a bang. We were just oversubscribed. We struggled initially, but it's been great. It's been amazing. We had a lot of the traditional people that drove around from new restaurant to new restaurant, and that reaffirmed that we were on the right track, but it also concerned us that, you know, we didn't want to be just this fad that had just happened. The space was in existence since the 40s, and we were blessed in that when we stripped the tiles, we found the old original red oxide floor, which was imperfect and it had irregularities in and it was uneven, but that was real, that was honest, it's something that you couldn't recreate. And we also had a Rhodesian teak parquet floor, which was part of the restaurant, which we were blessed to have found as well. So we just restored that, and I think that adds to the ambience, and we carried it through, the whole authenticity. People own the recipes in our business. They've been part of the success. So we called the chef and the bar crew and one or two of the waiters, and we said, you know, we want to do these milkshakes. What do you think? And everyone chipped in, and we had ideas, and we had a lookbook and a couple of visuals, and then we landed up with these three milkshakes that we called O-Shakes. We have a caramel delight, which I would recommend Amanda has. It's a little bit more sophisticated. It's not as messy as the others. It's got a creme brulee flavoring that we mix into the ice cream, and it has a cheesecake as well on top. It's one of the more popular ones, topped with some Rolo sweets.
Rock and roll breakfast, I hope.
Wait for it.
Sticking with the theme, I hope.
Wait for it.
Oh, no, man, no. Uh-huh. Not for breakfast. Milkshakes for breakfast.
In a jar. Oh, this looks
like... I must say, these are the best looking
milkshakes.
These are the best looking milkshakes I've ever seen.
No, these deserve a Snapchat. You guys are joking. What?
Wow, three milkshakes.
Milkshakes.
Is this all for us?
No, that's breakfast.
This is breakfast.
Where's my phone? I have to take a selfie. That's not the most rock and roll breakfast I've ever seen, then I don't know what
is. I don't know.
Hey, where do we start?
I think just dig in. If I have a child and it's my child's birthday, they don't need a party. They just need one of these milkshakes.
Isn't it? If I die right now, right here, life's been good. Surely there's no better milkshake in all of Johannesburg.
There's none. I have to describe this to you. This is actually a caramel milkshake. This bit that I'm busy biting into right now is cheesecake. It has Rolos, like real cheesecake, like an entire cheesecake slice. Mm. No. This is like a chocolate brownie. Mm.
How rock and roll are we? Milkshakes for breakfast.
Can you handle?
Mm. The cheesecake is to die for. It's a pretty crazy way to start the day.
You can have my last one.
Oh, thank you. We've just had the best brekkie milkshakes in town at Craft in Parkhurst. Now we're heading on our way into Melville to a rock and roll bar, a very famous rock and roll bar that goes by the name of Hell's Kitchen.
So Hell's Kitchen is very much set in the 1920s and it has a very rock and roll kind of feel. It's the perfect place if you want to go for afternoon drinks, after work drinks, dinner, or if you just straight up want a party. And it's the kind of place that accepts you the way you are. You don't even have to dress up. Very much like Craft.
Here we go, Hell's Kitchen.
Perfecto. Here is the parking. You turn around.
I'm John O'Kirby, one of the owners of Hell's Kitchen Melville. A couple of friends of ours in the industry got together, decided that it was time to do something together, and we thought, are we going to chase the money, or let's do something we really want to do? And we kind of sat down, formulated this plan, and we find ourselves here. We've kind of focused on crafty stuff. So a big seller is gin. There's lots of very interesting gins coming out of Cape Town and some Joburg, but more so Cape Town. And obviously your craft beers, our craft beer on tap flies. The food is big portions, think American diner. And obviously there's a specific look and feel to the venue that seems to appeal to a lot of people, the right people that we're looking for. We've got a lot of the tattoo crowd, we've got some hipster crowd, some of the bearded people, we've got some biker people, just an interesting mix of all sorts. The restaurant side of it is full kind of every night of the week, 7 days a week, but Friday, Saturday are when it gets a bit loose.
Okay, we're doing our signature HK burger. It's 250-gram patties. We don't use these frozen patties that most restaurants get. We clean a full chuck and a full brisket ourselves. Our buns that we use, we also make ourselves every morning and sometimes at night if we need more for the night shift. Yeah, it's a power burger, dude. Like, it's a lot of meat, pure meat. We don't want to add any of these extra, like, sauces or anything. We want you to actually taste the meat itself, and that's what I think a chuck and a brisket does. It's got a lot of flavor and it's very filling as well. It's a big ass burger.
Yeah. Explain it.
So it's locally made whiskey, three year aged, and it's just infused with cinnamon at the end. There's a product in the States which is it's also hugely popular, fastest selling whiskey in North America, and this is kind of our South African, more interesting version of it.
Let's have a shot.
I'm not sure I want to taste, but what are the tastes that come through here in terms of flavor? Is that how you pour it?
I guess you're having a shot, Amanda.
That's happening. The flavors you'll get are a bit of spicy regret.
Spicy regret. It smells like fireballs. You know the sweets?
Yeah, exactly. The fireballs as a kid, you remember? Like little small cinnamony, spicy.
Oh, that smells amazing. Oh, that's beautiful.
Thanks, bud.
Oh, cool. Fit cook and mauta.
What is this?
Deep fried mac and cheese.
We're going to share.
Ew, I'm so full from breakfast.
Not exactly banting this meal, eh?
It looks juicy, though.
The chipotle aioli is a jalapeno mayo, so it's a little spicy. You can give that a try as well, if you like.
Can I have another shot of hellfire?
Absolutely.
Fried mac and cheese, I've never seen that. Can I slice this in half?
Have a bite. Go. Cheers, brother.
Cheers, bud.
My wife lets me out one night, I'll come here.
Nice. I'll host you.
Thank you.
Awesome.
There's one last thing that we've missed out on, though. You wanted to know, come on. Don't be shy,
John. I want to know what happens in the secret room.
We do birthdays and bachelorette parties and that kind of stuff. I have stuck my head in there a couple of times and there's been like a 15-person game of strip poker going on. It's very entertaining. Just leave a card, a pack of cards in there every now and again. It's very entertaining. Yeah.
Do you need a VIP pass or can we go check it out?
Yeah, absolutely.
Can I have a look?
Pull in.
I'll finish this later. Nice bookshelf.
Oh, little bookshelf. Nothing going on here.
Harry Potter vibes!
It's a heavy door.
There we go.
Wow. Now, I always wanted to have one of these as a young boy. It's great. And this is where the magic happens.
Huh? This is where stuff goes down.
All right, so what happens in the secret room stays in the secret room. See you later.
Hell's Kitchen was a vibe, eh? If I was 10 years younger and I didn't have three children and I wasn't married, I'd be hanging out there.
Yeah, look, I'll be honest with you. It's clearly the place you come to. I would say it's perfect for, like, you know, after hours, after work, or, like, if you're looking to really turn up and let loose, you know?
Like, properly.
Like real. Yeah.
Okay, so potato head, our next spot is potato shed.
Not head.
I said potato head, our next spot is potato shed.
Potato head.
I just did. Okay, I'm just gonna have a bit of a snooze. Wake me up when we get here.
You shouldn't be drinking fireball whiskey.
Not during the day.
You're not even directing me, but it's fine. I'm a woman,
just
I'm
drive.
Efficient, I'll find my.
Stop talking.
Welcome to the Potato Shed. I'm Myra Kutsudakis. I'm the co-owner with my husband John of the heritage gem that is the Potato Shed in Newtown Junction in the Market Theatre district of Jozi. The Potato Shed is a 1911 heritage gem. This is where they would like offload the vegetables for the whole city. And it's got like an earthiness and a grittiness that's just so much part of who we are. So I thought we absolutely have to take this and turn it around into something that's accessible again to a contemporary audience. Our lamb on the spit is absolutely famous. It's a signature dish, but also we've got gorgeous prime ribs, just beautifully seared, really honest dishes where the provenance is king. You know, that's what it's about, just beautiful, well-aged cuts, seared, very interesting flavor profiles. And then obviously the hero is the potato. The potato, which is honest, democratic, accessible to everyone, that's what we love about it. But you can't believe the amount of ways that we can turn this baby around.
Chef, what are you preparing for us?
So we are going to be doing a prime rib that we're going to start on the grill and then finish off in our forno. That's going to be served with a stuffed potato, Hasselback, and grilled caper butter corn.
Overwhelmed before I even indulge.
It's a feast.
Myra, is it because you're Greek? Because we've been doing the show for a couple of weeks and this is the most food we've ever had to eat in our lives.
I told you, Greeks express their love through food. This is food, this is love. It's a slow cooked happiness.
We're only two human beings, eh?
I'm also tucking in, I also count.
You know what has really intrigued me? For me, I grew up with my grandmother having these in her kitchen. And also, this is, I'm not sure if you guys call it corn or, you know.
Those are mealies.
Yes, mealies, and it looks so close to home. Is there a story behind having these cups or it's just a...
Amanda, it's heritage, eh? We're in such a, this is part of history. And what is the history of the Market Theatre, of Jozi, of Newtown? It's all of this, you know what I mean? Yeah. But hopefully it's a bit like deconstructed and a bit sexied up and, you know, just mixed it up a little bit. That comes from the wood burning oven. The furno, as we call it. And then here are the soy glazed mushrooms that were stuffed in with the cheese on top. So just make sure you get some of the mushrooms in there as well, because those are the flavors like plain.
Listen, that lamb is phenomenal.
Yeah.
Hey, Janez?
The lamb is delish.
I'm not talking anymore.
Okay.
But you know, you're tasting, which is cool. It's just that lemon and those oils and whatever, like basted with herbs on the skin. That's why it's so gorgeous.
This is what we made.
Yeah. This is what you cook. So go ahead, have that. I'm also going to grab some.
And I can taste the meat.
So this is the rib with, on the bone. This is a single like fillet, grain-fed Karen beef, delish. And then it's, there's a fennel salad, fennel and parmesan and greens. You know what I mean? You want to just have that.
Officially, this is the best dessert I've ever had. What is it?
Woo! Okay. Well, that means a lot. Right? It's fire and ice. Basically, it's a ice cream dessert that comes out of our cathedral to fire. It comes out of the wood burning oven. So it's kind of nostalgia. What did you love as a kid when you saw fire? Marshmallows on the fire. So it's basically got like a marshmallow meringue on the top. Inside, it's got like chocolate cake drizzled with pandahan, and then it's got little orange segments, so you've got that like citrus, and it's baked in the oven, and it just comes out as liquid, gooey gorgeousness.
And it's better than anything. You must be so proud of what you've accomplished here.
I love it. You know, this is happiness for me. This is the expression of design, food, and experience coming together. What life's about.
Guys, to Greece, to Potato Shed, to Newtown, and to cheers in mugs.
Yeah, mugs. Cheers. Cheers, guys.
Definitely my new favorite. It's got my granny mugs.
Woo!
What happens in the secret room stays in the secret room.
Bye!
This is scary.
It's a heavy door. Cool. Let's get the alcohol. Let's get the booze. Can you switch that camera off?